Okay, YouTube friends, so right here behind us we got some live edge slabs for our picnic tabletop. Planed up the bottom a little, cut a couple of 2x6s, getting ready to glue them together and then screw those 2x6s down to help hold it together. There might still be a little gap, but I'll either mix some of the cedar sawdust with glue and fill it, or I might do a pour over lacquer. I haven't decided on finish, but I'm just getting ready to glue it. Nails construction adhesive I'm going to glue it with. So. Okay. I'm going to cinch this up a little before we screw it down. Thank you. There we go. Now the construction adhesive will hold it together for a long time, whereas the screws will hold it while that sets up. But there we go. Now I need to dig out some more cedar 2x6s and get some more stuff. Okay, here we go. I'm going to plane these up. Just that way if your leg brushes up against them or something, it's not all rough. There we go. We'll start cutting up some angles here in a minute and put the legs together. Okay, so sat down and did some thinking, a little bit of reading, and I did a 28 degree angle. And I'm going to try making them 32 inches long. I think that'll be a decent height, just measuring off other tables and stuff, and then I'll have to figure out exactly where I'm going to put my cross piece, and I still need to figure out how long that one's going to be. But use the speed square trick to get the, well, not trick, just used it to get the 28. And it was quite a while before I figured this out, but you got the marks here. So then you just, yeah. Get your 28, just set it down, and you bring it right up on that pivot, 28, make a mark, there you go. So I have one now, these are a little inchecked, I've cut two actually, so then I'll just go the easy way, just lay this down, mark it out, and I'll make my two cuts. Then the next one will be right back there. So I'll back you up here a little. Cut the next two legs. And then we'll be time to figure out the cross pieces. Grab a chair. This is how I think I'll decide on my height is it's fairly comfortable. I'd like it just a touch higher. So I'm thinking maybe 18 inches. So I think these are 2 inches thick. Just under. So by the time I get them all finished out, they'll probably be an inch and a half. So I should pick which side of these I want to be the bottom. Like on this one, I'll have this little included bark on the bottom. So it's going to sit like that. So 16 and a half inches up. I'll make a line. And in theory, I should actually just be able to make my marks there. There's the other one. By the time I get my straight line, in between the two, should be at that 28 degree. We're getting there. Excuse me, Amy. Pardon me, Amy. Excuse me, Amy. So here we go. Got my wife with a square on the far side holding that straight up and down. And then I'm going to mark it with the speed square, and that's going to give me my two angles. Still good? Mm-hmm. So we believe that gives me my two angles and my measurement. You can let go. Then